What's going on, YouTube? So today, Vagabond Builds coming at you with a 2022 Audi Q8 55 TFSI, yes, Quattro and all that good stuff, S-Line package. And we're gonna be explaining that later on in the video. But before we start the review of the exterior, interior, and some specs about the car, please subscribe and like. And a special shout out to Rockland Audi here at Rockland, California in the greater Sacramento area. All right, let's start. So starting off with this beautiful front end on this 2022 Audi Q8, this is the S-Line Plus package, so you are going to be seeing some slight differences. But to start off, from the 2021 to the 2022, we don't see much difference in the front grille, but you will see on the S-Line Plus package the black trim all around the car, and we're going to be showing you guys that through the video. You do have the black also Audi emblem. Now you do have your camera here integrated right under the emblem, and along with your standard bumper sensors going across this bumper cover, so nothing much has changed. Same kind of here, you do get that airflow coming into those vents. Beautiful headlight LED lighting that you have with high beam assist on these headlights, but get a hold of that nice character. Nothing much has changed on the headlights either. So pretty much basic and straight to the point, but a beautiful front end on this S-Line Plus package. Now moving over to the side, you do have the 22-inch V design bi-color rim with the adaptive suspensioning system. You do have the ABS with brake assist on this car, but on this S-Line Plus package, I just want to make known to you that you do get the 22-inch rims. You will be seeing other packages like the style packages with the 21-inch rims, but this exact package does come with the 22-inch rim. So I'm a huge fan of these V-style shaped rims. Beautiful look on this red also. You got kind of that like dark gray black look with that machine surface silver, or that chrome silver look. Do have this, I'm a huge, another huge fan of the trim piece here being the same color as the car. That's very nice. And of course you do have the S-Line badge stamped here on the rear side of the front fenders. Now coming over to the door, you do have the side mirror, same color as the car, along with a little bit of black trim. Now, not the same black trim that you have on the front car of the car. That's the glossy black trim. This is kind of more of a matte plastic trim finish with your integrated side marker and your integrated camera here into this side mirror. You do have the lane assist and emergency assist also on this car. So full tech package on that part. Very nice door. Very straight to the points. Now, remember I was saying also from the front, you do have the matching gloss black trim from the front matching this side trim piece here, kind of giving it a nice race aggressive look on this car being that S-Line. Over to the side, again, you have the black gloss trim around the windows. Now you do have the aluminum top rails on this exact package itself with the panoramic glass on this car. It does have a tilt and slide option on this SUV. Coming over to the rear part of the car. So here on the rear end, what do we see? We see this very, very nice LED bar going across this whole rear end. Super beautiful, a stamp from Audi that we see. Very nice linear LED tail lights. A lot of character, letting you know that's very beautiful on Audi. Now again, you do have the black gloss trim piece with that black emblem, like I was saying, on the front side of the car with your badges Q8 in the same exact color. Quattro stamp here, letting you know it's an all-wheel drive, and you have that black trim here and also on this side here. Now, what I love about this car is that it gives it kind of a nice race aggressive look with this black trim. Also on the lower part of the bumper, near kind of the diffuser or valence area, you also have that black trim, standard bumper sensors integrated. Very nice look. I mean, it kind of gives it a nice midnight look. Do you have your tow package here with your plug-ins? Now this bottom kind of diffuser or valence area, it is kind of a matte gray look on this. So Very nice, a lot of character going on this rear end. Just take a look also at this rear quarter panel, just how wide it sits and just that very nice shape that Audi gives this 2022 Q8, just very beautiful. Again, not much has changed either on this rear end, but just kind of an update. Now let's go ahead and enter the trunk of the car by the push of the button. Automatic electric open, very nice and quiet, convenient. We first see this silver kick plate on this backside of this trunk. Very nice, a lot of space on this trunk. Now, if you do need more space and you don't have the kiddos with you or the dogs or whatever, you can put those seats forward by lifting the lever on the interior of the car. But one thing that I want to show you guys here is by the push of these buttons here, you can drop the rear end on this car and you can also lift it with regards to your towing. So if you want to drop that by the push of the button, it'll drop. Kind of nice personal space, 12 volt outlet here on the left. A little bit more personal space. Lifting this carpet up, you pretty much have the spare tire with your tire inflator and all that good stuff. You don't have personal belongings area here, so you can't see, or for the eye to not see. I would have liked Audi to make a little bit of personal area here under a mat. So it's pretty cool. You do have your trunk cover. You can pull that just like that. Very nice. You want to finesse that. Okay, and then you have your nice, beautiful lighting. Very cool look. Kind of more sporty on that lighting, also making it those like LED bars. All right, pretty much done with the trunk. Now, by the push of a button, you do have that automatic close. Very nice. Classy clothes. So we're pretty much done with the exterior. Let's go ahead and enter the interior of the car. So coming into the car, one thing that I want to notice is that open assist door. So at the pull of that lever, that door just kind of pop open by that electric motor. Very nice. Now taking a look at the door panel, you do see first a Bang and a Olufsen premium sound system. Very big fan of that sound system, the 3D sound all around the car. This is very nice. You kind of have that Pando gray color is what they call it on the interior part of this car. So it's kind of a darker gray look per se. And you have your nice kind of wood grain look, also with a little bit of matte silver embedded or inserted into the trim panels of this door panel. Now you do kind of have that nice, very lighting bar that you'll see when it's dark inside the car, and we'll try to get a pic of that. You do have your typical and standard window control unit panel here. You do have the two memory stage for your driver's seat. So whoever's driving, mom or dad or whoever, you can set up to two memories, unlock and locking. Another thing is you do have on the S-Line package, this kick plate here on the bottom on this door sill, you have the S-Line kick plate that lights up. So that's a pretty cool feature on these S-Lines. Now coming to sit inside the car. Feels pretty good. Now, one thing that you're gonna notice about these Audis on the S-Lines also is more of a stiff seat. It's not gonna be as luxurious as Mercedes, but it's also not going to be as stiff and sporty as, I don't know, let's say a Lamborghini. So you're going to kind of be in between. It's kind of like a sport luxury feel inside this car. Now you do have the side holsters that allow you to kind of feel like seats grabbing you. Very nice electric seating here on the driver and also on the passenger. You do have your heated seats along with your ventilated seats on the front end. Now very nice kind of perforated gray leather look, same color throughout the seat. It's very nice. And coming over also here on this left side panel, you have a touch sensitive panel here for your lighting control unit. So by the push, and you'll hear a little click as you press that button down, and you'll go into auto mode, or you'll go into side marker, I mean your parking markers, or you'll go into just if you want to manually turn it on or off. Coming over also to the steering column, you do have your electric steering column, which is very convenient. All depends what you feel and your opinion. Some people like the manual, but this being kind of more of a higher end classy car,
I do like the electric steering column. Very nice leather stitch steering with that same type of gray, kind of matte silver look. You do have your manual button controls with your paddle shifters right behind the steering wheel. Typical rods for your signal lights and your windshield wipers and all that good stuff. Coming over to the infotainment center, I'm going to be turning on this infotainment center for the sake of the video. I'm going to turn it on, and as you can see, you do have the memory steering column along with the memory seating. And let's continue as a guest. It's okay. And this is what your home looks like. Now, when you first turn on the car, you do see you got your digital front display on your cluster along with the infotainment center. And then you also have everything digitalized for your temperature controls on this quad zone climate control. So everybody gets their own zoner temperature setting, which is pretty cool. Now, starting off with the cluster, pretty cool, you can change the views on the cluster. So by the click of this manual push on that cluster, you can minimize those RPM wheels with that mile per hour wheel. See that? And what you do is you get a bigger screen of that front GPS, and then we can kind of scroll through what we want on the info on the front cluster of that. So that's pretty cool. And then you have your heating. Do have your heating gauge here and on the right, which is pretty cool. Coming over, sorry, keeps turning off, but you do have your home, you have navigation system, and this has MMI touch sensitivity, so you will be feeling kind of a vibration as you press on it. And you have the iOS Android support on this car, the Audi support on this car, so that's pretty cool. Now, you do have your info if you press on the vehicle and you want to find out like live data, things like that, about suspension, the AC and parking gate and your 360 camera visualization. It's all there. So fully loaded with that, the bells and whistles, very nice. Along with the temperature controls. Now this is also touch sensitive, which it's one of the few cars that you see that a lot of these new cars do still put those manual buttons in for the temperature controls. I don't know how I feel about that. I kind of like the manual idea, but I also like the touch sensitivity kind of coming into this new tech era. Again, there it goes, turning it off. But that's pretty cool on the touch sensitivity for that. So it's kind of giving you more like a futuristic feel that you're getting everything that is digital inside this car. You do kind of have the manual knob here, so you could turn that down and turn it up and change your stations going through that, all that good stuff. 12-volt outlet here with your cup holders. Nice cup holders, pretty deep so your cups aren't toppling over. Very nice on this shift knob here, parking button, along with, you got to push that button on the left and move it in and out of drive and parking and all that good stuff. Coming over, very nice leather stitch top armrest, lifting that open. USB ports, the USB-C inputs, you know, one for the driver, one for passenger. Would have liked to seen a little bit bigger personal space here, but hey, again, it's all opinion. Put that down. Go ahead and lift that. Whoop. You can move this up just like that. Sorry. And then move it back by the click of a button. You kind of have a little bit of change space or whatnot. So we're pretty much done, let's say, on the front. One more thing. You do have the nice electric controlled visor for that panoramic glass sunroof. And by the click of a button, you can push that back. Just like that, and you get that sunroof open, very nice, quiet as it's opening, which is pretty cool. And as you can see, you have kind of this nice jet black cloth dressing up this ceiling on the interior part of this car. Very cool. You do have your lighting for your night purposes if you're looking for something and all that good stuff. Beautiful dressed leather dashboard with the stitching going through. Very nice, classy feel. And again, before I forget, on this car, you do have the heads-up display. So you will be seeing on the front windshield your miles per hour and lane assist control on that heads-up display that is integrated into your dashboard, which is very cool feel. Now, look at also this black gloss trim kind of to match the outside trim piece. Very nice, classy, rich, elegant feeling along with that wood grainy look.
Loving it, but not too luxurious feel, but kind of on the sporty side, which I'm a huge fan of. Do have your locked glove compartment here like standard. And we're pretty much done on the front part of this car. Let's head over to the back. Now on the back side of this interior, of this 2022 Q8, something that I want to mention is coming into this car, we're gonna see as we shut this door nice and soft, it does have the soft assist close on these doors, which is a super cool feature to have. Now looking at the door panel, you do have kind of the same color configuration. Again, you have that kind of nice lighting bar that changes colors. You will see kind of the red or the white going through there. Same kind of woodsy, grainy trim insert into this, along with your ashtray. Whoever smokes, I mean, don't smoke, it's bad for you. But you have that also integrated into the backside. If you want to put some trash in there or something, that's also pretty cool. You can control your windows here. Now, you do have your visor. Let's turn that on. And you can control that visor by a switch here. So if you got that sun beating in your face, you can throw that up and enjoy maybe a nap if you're taking a long road trip. Let's put that down. It's pretty cool. Look at that lighting bar change from blue to red and all that. It's very nice. A lot of character to this car. A lot of leg room on this back seat. So you know you're not going to be squished or feeling all claustrophobic. Very nice net for your personal space. Nice, beautiful back. It does kind of slant down as it's coming over to the floor. Again, coming over to this back side of this center console. Remember I was saying you do have the quad zone temperature setting, so everybody gets to by that touch sensitive panel control whatever they like on that. Now you do have the heated seating also on the back row. Big fan of the heated seat. Get heated seats wherever you can. And on the back row you have a nice armrest by the push of a button. You have these little bitty teeny cup holders, which is like, what are you going to put in there? An Izzy can, but I wish they would have made them just a bit bigger so you can put maybe some bottles in there. Then you have your armrest, and it's kind of in the way a little bit. So if you are resting your arm or if this is in the way, so take that into consideration. You're going to be hitting that constantly if, you know, you have this open with your can. But another cool feature that this car has is by the push of a button, you can bring down this center of this back row seating. So if you have some skis you want to throw back there and head up for the weekend and you got four people and you don't want to, you know, touch this seat or this seat, you can just put that center seat down and throw something longer. Or if you want to go to Home Depot and carry a 2x4, but get a truck for that. Don't put your wood in this car. And we can put that back up. And let me show you something also cool that you can move this seat up and this seat by a lever goes forward and goes all the way back just like that. It's kind of upright. I would have wished to kind of see this seat kind of incline a little bit more back, kind of giving you a little bit better angle on that lower back for looking at a longer drive. You have your reading lights here and here for the nighttime purposes if you're looking for something, and of course your hanger for your clothing line or whatnot, and your O Shiznit handle. One thing also I want to show you guys, like I was mentioning it prior in the video, is you can put these seats down. Now this lever puts this seat down, and along with that lever, so this whole back bench comes down and connects to that trunk, so you're having that full space if you're looking to carry something a little bit more large or long. It's pretty cool. Let's put that lever up just like that. And don't forget the car seats. The car seats, you can, by the lifting of these little plastic caps, you can attach your car seat to that, up to two car seats and a person in the middle. So we're pretty much done with the backside of this interior of this car. Let's go ahead and talk about the specs on this motor. All right, so some specifications of this exact motor. Now, this particular one is the 3.0 liter V6 model with the turbocharged, and it comes about 335 horsepower and 369 pounds-feet of torque. Now, you do have the option to get these in the turbo diesels and also the V8 twin turbos. For the S line, you will have the 500 horsepower, and for the RS line, you have the 591 horsepower. The miles per gallon consumption is 18 city, 23 highway, and a combined of 20 with an all-wheel drive 8-speed automatic transmission. Now that we're pretty much done on this car, thank you so much for watching, guys, and please subscribe again and like. Now, if you do happen to watch our videos and you do want to come in and buy one of these cars, tell them Vagabond Build sent you. And thanks so much again for watching. Stay tuned, we got some pretty cool things coming.